Why did you come here and seek asylum in the first place? What was the reason that you came to Sheffield?
I was faced for reason I come in Sheffield. I was faced political reason. So I've been took some picture about the demonstration in Cameroon, the city called Mboueyeu. So when the government were not happy how the newspaper will tell about the story, because the government don't lie sometimes, the truth, when you put it there on truth, is you against the government. So that's why I've been faced on the situation, and then I feel myself here. One Asian bring me in this country.
You were taking pictures of demonstrations.
Yeah.
Why are people demonstrating in Cameroon?
It's like when you apply university in Sheffield.
Yeah.
And then when you wait your name to be on board, you come, you don't find your name. You see someone name, who did they even pay the student fee? So it was a lot of stuff going on, and then people protest, go on street. And then the city is not very big. Everyone know each other. And then when the demonstration come, all over, people are involved. And then the government say, call the student, people who come on the street, I don't know how to say the word. They treat people like, I don't know the word. So they treat people who come so a broken stuff in university, they won't call them, it's not the student, but it was student protest. But the government want to prove people, say, people who will do the damage will come from outside the university. So me, I feel myself, the police take my camera and break it. And then I feel myself, I was going to fight with police. So now it's like they say I'm involved, I made the demonstration or the part of the demonstration. I wasn't. I was take just the picture.
So all you did was take pictures of a demonstration.
Yeah.
And after that, you were arrested. And then what happened after the arrest? What happened then?
When they arrest me, they take me in police station. And then when you bring you in police station, no matter what you say, they're not gonna listen. They just beat you up, and then chuck you in the detention. It was not just me; it was a lot of people. That's the reason they took you. They don't want you to say something, because what you do, they say you're against the government. So you feel yourself inside the detention because you come to do your own job. Because they say photographer, new journalist, they're the same. They tell the different story. They don't tell the truth.
What happened after that? What did you decide to do?
I was lucky because those were not just me in detention. There were also those journalists and students. So we were lucky because those people for demonstration come out, start arguing police station, and then they break the police station, and then everyone escaped. And then that's my lucky I escaped, and then I feel myself outside. So the police station was burned, the police car, everything was burned. So now it's the reason if I go back, I'm gonna face on the prosecution, because they say they don't class me again like the photographer, they've classed me like people who come and destroy the government stuff. That's the main reason I'm here.
So if you go back to Cameroon, you will be seen as a criminal.
And
also a criminal who is attacking the government.
Yeah, attacking the government, yeah. Because I've been on that position, they take me in detention. People come and break it. We always escape. So you're gonna see, I see the people who destroy the government, the material, car also. That's why now I face, if you are going to Cameroon. Now, when you go to immigration, so They're going to find my name, and then from there, they're going to take from me. I'm going to be faced with the prosecution.
You've traveled hundreds of miles from Cameroon
yeah.
to come here. How was it like leaving your country and leaving your friends and leaving your family?
It's very, very painful because when you left your family, my dad is not in love. My mom also have all my two sisters, so I still miss them. But how are I gonna do? I can't go back. So and then when you come to a different country, you have to start everything with the base, and nothing. And then you think you're safe. Now you face the situation, you have to ask the question, you have to give. No matter how you do, if they don't believe you, they say you made the story. As now I face all this situation, see myself again in detention. I should be safe, but I feel myself again in detention.
What was it like coming to the UK for the first time? Like, it's a big change.
Yeah, it's a big change, especially the weather, the language. Even in Cameroon, we speak, my country is a bilingual. I speak French, but I come for French speaking because in Cameroon, the government is more French, but they try to put the English part very low profile. So that's why, and then all these protests also against the low profile of English part of Cameroon. So they want to be here, but they don't, the French government, they don't bother about them. They just ignore them.
People in power don't believe that if you go back to Cameroon, that you are a criminal.
Yeah, they say my life is safe in Cameroon. But I said last time to immigration officer, I said, I would like to go back, but where is my safety? But they said they can't guarantee my safety. That's the problem. Because I've been going on with this problem now nearly 5 years. I've been here, nothing been done. So also, when you got the label, being asylum seeker, it's like you're criminal. You can't do everything. You want to do something for your life because you can't stay like this. Even you meet a woman, how you gonna explain yourself? But sometimes those people feel like they can't talk about themselves. I'm asylum seeker. But me, how I grow up, my mom used to tell me, you have to tell the truth, because if you don't tell the truth, you're gonna catch you up. And then what I do, when I met Sharon on friend house about the party, I tell her, look, I'm asylum seeker, so I don't want to be involved, because when you meet a woman, they say you want to marry to save your asylum case, but it wasn't me. So I tell her the first day, I can't tell you what next, because I see waiting the decision for home office, because I don't know what to do. My destiny is now in the hand on the home office. It can maybe tomorrow say no. I don't know what's going to happen. But I'm grateful if they give me a chance to go and stay with my family and make my life. That's why I'm hope.
If you have any words of advice for other asylum seekers, not just in the UK but across the world, what would that advice be?
My main thing is to keep faith and then keep fighting to prove your own identity, to prove, say, to be asylum seeker is not the end of the world, because behind the asylum seeker, you got your own profession, what to give back to the country where you are.
There has been phenomenal media support, and the support online has been colossal. When you Google your name, you get pages and pages about Bernard. How does it feel for total strangers to be 100% behind you?
Like I said before, when you just come anywhere in the world, you have to fit in the criteria, like in English way, you have to follow how people live in UK. also on your city. And then when I come, they ask me, say, they got a vast voluntary action Sheffield to get busy, to not think about a lot. Say, I didn't even know when I went there, give my name, and then they say, what do you want to do, volunteer? I never get that word before, because in French they call bénévolat. But here is do a voluntary job. So I take my chance. I say I'm gonna learn the new one. And then when you volunteer, you meet a lot of people, and then you make friends, and then you can go and chat with them, forget about your situation. And then I was lucky, I met Mohamed Shafak, who was a counselor, Liberal Democrat. And then I started involved those charity. And then he tell me, say, look, you have to be focused and do what you want. And then I take it from there and always give 100% what I do. So he pay me. That's why I was very popular. Media, everyone want to involve to give me back what I give.
Bernard, you live your life with a smile, and you also live it by giving back what you give, and it's fantastic to finally meet you, and thank you very much for joining me today.
Thank you very much to have me. Thank you. Bye.